And here's Paris. Look how big she got. Hey everyone, it's Kaye again here. Welcome back to my channel. Today, it's actually gonna be slightly different. If you didn't know before, now you know, I have a giant Flemish bunny. I've shown her a couple times on this channel, but now it's been like 3 months since I've shown her and she's grown so big. So today I'm gonna go over an update on her so you can get a feel for what she's doing and how she's doing. And also as a bonus, she has on a Christmas costume. So stay tuned because she looks super cute. And here's Paris. Look how big she got. She's no longer a baby. She's definitely a lot heavier. One of her favorite things is to get pet. I'm gonna do a weigh-in later so we can see just how much more weight she's put on ever since her baby years. So if you don't know, I'm just gonna go over a few quick facts about giant Flemish bunnies. And if you want any additional information, just go to the other two videos that are linked below in the description. So I know she's super adorable, but I'm going to go over some like factors that you should consider before deciding whether having a giant Flemish bunny is actually the right decision for you. For starters, the four things that I deem are the most important is space, food, of course, healthcare. So you have to learn a bit about this kind of bunny because they are different than like the typical bunny that you could own. And the last factor is time. So one of the biggest challenges of owning a giant Flemish is the fact that they are huge and they're very fast. So if you want one, I would say if you live in an apartment, it's probably not the ideal environment for them. Unless of course you want to take them on walks outside, but I don't know, I've never really done that with her yet. But I might try it out and see how that goes. But what I do know is you have to make sure that you have enough space for them to run around, hop around, and get a lot of exercise in. Typically what I do is I actually let her run outside during the day in an enclosed backyard. So that's the ideal environment if you're gonna have a giant Flemish, because then they won't stray away from their home, and instead they're given free range to run and play however they want, but it's a safe, enclosed space. I definitely would not recommend keeping them in cages. Ooh, look at all her fluff, she's super fluffy. Keeping them in cages because it's just too restrictive and they need to get their exercise. They're actually very prone to gaining weight because they eat a lot, which I'm gonna go over too. So it's really important that they stay very active so they stay very healthy. One thing to make sure that you remember though is if you do leave her outside, ensure that the plants that you have planted in your backyard are actually safe for her to nibble on, because she will be doing a lot of that. And also make sure that there are no pesticides and no chemicals in the back, because you know, she is an animal, she'll roam and see, you know, the different things that are around. So just make sure that it's an actual safe environment for her. And then also another thing that I do is I make sure I bring her in at night. When she comes back in, she gets her big meal, she gets to sleep, and then wake up the next day, she gets to go out again and roam. So that's kind of the schedule that she's on. And the reason why I find it very, very important for her to be brought inside during the night is because there are wild animals out there that prey on rabbits, such as coyotes, et cetera, et cetera. So I just make sure to take this one extra step to keep her safe and sound. Fact to consider before getting a giant Flemish bunny is of course food. As you can see, she is very, very big for a bunny. This kind of bunny typically eats pellets and vegetables. The pellets that she eats should be contain about 16% protein. I can give you an example of ones that I give her, and I'll link them below in the description. As far as vegetables go, she actually can eat a pound, roughly a pound a day of vegetables, fresh vegetables. That includes the likes of cilantro. This is actually one of her favorite ones, and I brought some out here in case she wants to nibble, but right now she's just enjoying her bunny massage. But she likes cilantro, spinach, corn, sweet potatoes, things like that. And when you pile it up and you give it to her, you will notice that she'll go through it very, very fast, and this is actually very normal. So make sure that if you are considering this kind of bunny, you do have the budget and the means to be able to provide her healthy, nutritious vegetables every single day, as well as the pellets. And of course, she has fresh water, and that's her beverage of choice. So when it comes to what Paris enjoys, she actually has her favorite vegetables. I know this because she goes through them right away. Her favorites are corn, sweet potatoes. She loves cilantro, that's like her absolute favorite. She likes cabbage and spinach. But those three, especially sweet potatoes, corn stuff, you have to make sure that they're uncooked. She'll eat them raw, and that's the best way for her to eat them. And also, another thing that you can do as well, because, you know, rabbits like to nibble on things, is so you can get her toys. And also another thing that she enjoys is also hay, but the hay is placed in her enclosure where she sleeps at night. So she doesn't really eat that much because she has her favorites in there anyway. The third factor is time. I know, that's like pretty much the most valuable one, because if you don't have the time to take care of this kind of bunny, do not get him. As you can see, she has a very sweet personality, so it's very important that you actually have the time to sit around with her and play with her every single day. Compared to other bunnies, this is definitely a high maintenance bunny. Because she eats a lot, she also poops a lot. That being said, you need to stay on top of cleaning her enclosure. She does spend most of the day outside, but when she does come inside, you know, she still needs to go to the bathroom and she will soil her enclosure. So you have to make sure that you stay on top of cleanings. Every other day is preferred, but 3 to 4 days is also adequate, depending on, of course, how much of a mess is being made in her enclosure. Another really cool thing is because the foods that she eats have so many vitamins and minerals and nutrients in them, this actually can double as manure for your garden. And number four is healthcare. This is one that you wanna make sure that you pay a lot of attention to as well. Because of their fur, as you can see, her fur is very dense. She's actually prone to ear mites and fur mites. And if this does occur with your giant Flemish bunny, this will mean that you would need to take her to the vet. And of course, we all know medical bills can add up and get expensive. So you need to make sure that you have a budget set aside for her healthcare costs to be able to go see the vet if need be. Also, another thing to keep aware of is to ensure that whatever environment she's in is actually the ideal temperature for her. Of course, as I mentioned earlier, she has a lot of fur, so she tends to overheat in the summer. So if you're living in a warmer climate, you need to make sure that you have the resources to keep her cool, such as fans, air conditioning, iced water bottles, put in her enclosure or close to her litter box. Whatever the case may be, she needs to be able to remain cool. With all those four facts, it doesn't seem that hard. If you have all the resources available, it's actually not that hard to home a giant Flemish bunny. The only thing is, if you have any concerns or any questions, make sure you talk to whoever you are getting your bunny from. Ask all the questions and make sure that the environment that you're bringing your bunny in is, of course, safe for them. They are a lot of work, definitely a lot of work, but they're very docile. And look, I mean, look how cute she is. She's just been sitting here the whole time, just enjoying the petting. Like, how cute is that? She's a great bunny to have and has a very nice personality, but it's very, very, very important that you make sure that you have the resources to take care of her. And that's it, guys. Those are the four things to take note of when considering whether a giant Flemish bunny is the right fit for you. Look at you! She's definitely gaining weight at the right rate. What a good girl. And she's currently 12.5 pounds, almost 13. She's still growing. She's not even a year old yet. Her birthday was in April. So she's growing at a great rate. And that's it, guys. So thanks so much again for joining Paris and I. Happy holidays to everyone. Say bye, Paris. Bye.